Hi, today I'm going to be demystifying the world of DSP pricing. Why does it even need to be demystified? It's because in most industries, if you want to know what the price of something is, it's relatively easy to find out. If you want to find out what the price of gas is at your local gas station, you just drive and look at the sign outside. If you want to find out the price of a trip from San Francisco to New York, you would just go and type that into your local search bar, and you would get a pretty good reflection of the actual pricing for your trip. But if you want to find out what the price of a demand-side platform is, well, good luck with that. So today I'm going to be talking through the three big buckets of prices that demand-side platforms charge and the individual components that go into each of those buckets. Before I move on, if you're getting value from this content, please go ahead and subscribe so that you get the regular updates. All right, so let's get into it. The first bucket is the actual cost of the technology platform. Perhaps this is called the platform fee or the tech fee. This is the percentage that most DSPs are going to charge you for access to their platform. And unfortunately, the range of prices can be really large. It could be anywhere from at the low end, 5 or 6%, up to something as high as 15 or 20%. So what drives such a big range in terms of the prices? One is just scale. If you are a big advertiser or an agency holding company, you're going to be negotiating aggressively and you're going to be getting something at the lower end of that range. If you're a smaller buyer or frankly a little naive or new to the industry, you may not know what the going rate is and you may get told it's 15%. You negotiate and, you know, negotiate from 15% down to 12%. And you feel great about the fact that you've negotiated off 3-4 percentage points, not realizing that someone else is paying about half that rate. The other factor that plays in can be the whether it's a niche player or not that's serving as your DSP. If you are trying to get some unique services related to CTV or digital out of home, then you might find that you're dealing with a specialist player and the rates there tend to be on the higher side of the range that I gave. So what do you get for those services that the DSP is providing to you? You're going to get things like basic fraud detection, basic traffic protection. You're going to get access to the DSP's proprietary algorithm. One other thing that is interesting about this is, I keep referring to the percentage fee, because for the most part, the DSPs have done a good job in trying to align the industry around the idea that it's a percentage of the gross media. This is in contrast to the way traditional ad serving was billed on a CPM basis. For traditional ad serving, you might pay a 3-cent CPM or a 10-cent CPM. Most DSP tech fees are now done as a percentage of the media that is flowing through them. Bucket 2 is the data fees. And even though I call this bucket 2 rather than bucket 1, it can be significant. It can actually be a larger sense of your overall costs than the tech fee. So data fees, one of the first things to ask yourself is, if you're paying a data fee to the DSP, who is it actually going to? Is it you paying the DSP for access to the DSP's data, or are they just acting on behalf of a third party who has other proprietary data? If it's the latter, if it's the case that you're actually paying a third party, one thing to watch out for is the DSP making a markup on that data? In some cases, they may just be passing through the costs. So if there's a third party data vendor, the DSP may be making nothing, or they may be charging some kind of markup on top of it. And so those are some of the things that I would be asking my DSP if I was looking at data fees. The other thing to understand about data fees is they tend to be higher the more significant or more specialized the audience is. So if it's a very high quality audience, meaning lots of different targets are layered on, the audience itself may be actually quite small. And so as a result, to try to make up their revenue model work, the data provider or the DSP may end up really boosting up the price on those very specific segments. And so they tend to be the highest priced data segments out of everything. The other thing about data that is a little bit different than what we just talked about in the platform fee is it can be a percentage of the gross media, or it can be charged on a CPM basis. So you may find that a segment, for example, costs 20 cents CPM. Or you may find that either the data provider or the DSP has entered into some kind of arrangement where they say you get access to all of our data for some given percentage. The other thing that you need to ask yourself is how unique is this data? In the case of a DSP, they may not have unique data, but they may have a preferred partnership, or they may have access to some proprietary data. So it's important to understand how unique is the data that you are being charged for. The third bucket is management fees. And management fees, unfortunately, like the technology fees, can have huge ranges associated with them. But before we even get to that, what you may find is that your DSP may not even provide management services anymore. Some of the largest DSPs have realized from a cost perspective and a time, it's simply not worth their time and effort to provide management services. But for those that do, you may find that the fees range from anything from as low as 3% to as high as 20%. And the key to ask is, again, what are you getting for that 3%? The other interesting curveball that exists in this world is, of course, all things can be negotiated. And particularly if you're in a situation where you need help from your DSP in the short term, but you intend to go and build out a team or an operations team to do this yourself, you may end up in a hybrid situation. If you are discussing with a DSP and they say that they're prepared to do it for some period of time, this is the kind of thing that may be able to be waived, meaning charged for free for some period of time. So those are the three big buckets: the platform fee, the data fee, and the management fee. The last thing to leave you with on the mysterious world of DSP pricing is how this is actually used. What you're going to find is that if you are a buyer and you are submitting a bid into an auction, and let's say you think you're submitting a dollar bid into an auction, all of the fees that I've just mentioned first will be subtracted by the DSP. So let's say the management fee, the data fee, the tech fee added up to something like 20% on a given impression. You may find that the bid that's actually submitted into the auction on your behalf is not a dollar, but instead 80 cents. And so that's a particular thing that you need to be careful of when you're looking at how your media is performing, is what proportion of the media is actually going to these fees, because it's going to significantly impact your performance if it's too great an amount. Again, thanks for taking the time to watch. I hope this was useful.